Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make copper sulfate for those of you interested in the chemistry, and we'll show you three ways of doing it. In all of these methods, we'll need concentrated sulfuric acid that we already made in a previous video. In the first method, get a solution of 10 milliliters of 30% hydrogen peroxide and add 3 milliliters of concentrated sulfuric acid. It's going to heat up a lot, so be very careful. Now drop in 3 grams or so of copper metal. This can be obtained from pipes or wires. The copper metal will dissolve to form copper sulfate. While very simple, this method is not very efficient since a lot of hydrogen peroxide decomposes. A better method is to use nitric acid as your oxidant. First, get 30 milliliters of water and add 3 milliliters of nitric acid along with 5 milliliters of sulfuric acid. Then add in 6 grams or so of copper metal. The reaction will produce both copper sulfate and nitrogen dioxide gas. Because the gas is toxic, this must be performed outside or in a fume hood. When it stops fizzing, it's done. Now, copper sulfate can also be made electrochemically. Get a solution of 5 milliliters of sulfuric acid in 30 milliliters of water, and then place in 2 copper electrodes made of pipe or wire. Connect each terminal to a 6-volt battery or a 5-volt power supply. Make sure the electrodes don't touch. I'm using a battery for demonstration, but it's cheaper in the long run to use a power supply. Alright, let me adjust the camera. The negative electrode is generating hydrogen gas, which you can see bubbling out on the right electrode. The positive electrode is dissolving into the sulfuric acid as it's being oxidized by the electric current. The copper sulfate being generated turns the solution a blue color. This process as laid out is not very efficient because some of the copper ions being oxidized into the solution at the positive terminal is diffusing over to the negative terminal and being reduced back out of the solution. But there's actually a simple trick to get around this. This time start with a coiled bunch of wire and place it into the bottom of the container. Put over an insulating tube on the end you're connecting to the battery. This is to slow the decomposition of this end and make the electrode last longer. Connect it up to the positive terminal of the battery. Now here's the trick. Hang your negative electrode so that it's a good distance above your positive electrode. You'll see why in a minute. Connect it up to the battery and fill the cell with dilute sulfuric acid solution. You only want the negative electrode to bubble for best efficiency. If both electrodes bubble, then you'll need to lower the voltage or raise the top electrode even higher until the bottom electrode stops bubbling. As it runs, most of the copper sulfate generated stays near the positive electrode. By preventing the copper sulfate from reaching the negative electrode, the conversion efficiency is increased. That's the trick for making copper sulfate by home electrochemistry. Alright, no matter how you make it, to get your solid copper sulfate, you can boil down the mixture. Since there is going to be excess sulfuric acid, the mixture will never boil completely dry. But the copper sulfate will precipitate out right about now. Here is the fine copper sulfate powder in the sulfuric acid. Just filter it off and recycle the acid to make more copper sulfate. If you want very large crystals, just let the mixture evaporate instead of boiling it, and eventually you'll get these nice large crystals of copper sulfate. We'll be using copper sulfate in upcoming videos, so please subscribe, rate, and comment.